or the undrugged Tom Brokaw, or others now in the cable world. You have your choice between one lapdog of the Obama administration or another. And if anyone goes off course, like Clint Eastwood did, a man who they revered the day before, a man who was held up as an American icon, which he is now being called senile by the vermin on the left. People who are not fit to shine Clint Eastwood's shoes are now calling him senile because he dared make a mockery of King Obama. Let's go for another opinion on these issues, if there is a different opinion. Donald Trump on the Savage Nation. Donald Trump, welcome to the program. It's been a long time. Welcome. How are you?
It has been a long time, and I heard what you said about a very good friend of mine, Clint, and he's a great guy. He's as smart as they come, and they really brutalized him for no reason.
Do you know that they're calling him senile today, the left-wing press, Donald?
Terrible. It's terrible. Well, they're also blaming Mitt Romney for Egypt. That's one of the all-time greats. They've actually taken it, and they're blaming Mitt Romney, who has had nothing to do with Egypt. They're blaming him for the fall of Egypt.
How did they figure that out?
Well, that one is, to me, the all-time. No, I thought Clint... Actually, Clint was interesting, and he made some very good points, and I thought it was a whole interesting deal, and the next day he was just absolutely, to use your name, savaged.
Yeah, he was he was savaged in a negative.
he was.
So, Donald, what's going to be here? We have a candidate who we both like, Mitt Romney. We know he's a very decent man. We know he's a far more decent man than what we have in the White House. At least I will say that.
Well,
he's a good man. Donald, is he too good for the job?
Well, you can't say anybody's too good. It's the most important job in the world. The world is falling apart. We have a president who's the worst foreign policy president in history. You know, they used to say, oh, who could beat him on foreign policy? Anybody, because you look at what happened with all of his speeches in Egypt and everywhere. They're all blowing up and they all hate us. And he's a disaster on foreign policy. Mitt Romney is a very good man. He's a very smart man. I would like to see him be much tougher on Obama. They're all afraid to be tough on Obama. They don't want to insult him. They don't want to be called a racist, because any time you say anything bad about Obama, they call you a racist. And, you know, they don't want to be called a racist. And it's a terrible situation that's happening. But he has to be very smart and very, very tough. And if he's not, he's not going to win.
Well, here's the thing, Donald. The last time you and I spoke, 6 months ago, I think it was an email, I told you that Romney would not come on the Savage Nation. You were shocked, and it's still true. Why does he go to every left-wing news outlet in the country today, the Today Show? You name the left-wing pressure group, he goes to them. I represent millions of independent voters. You know and I know something's wrong with his campaign team. Isn't that true, Donald?
Well, you know, they've been very nice to me, and I do respect them. And I must tell you, I told them that I think you should go on your show and go on very quickly. You have a great audience. You have a big audience and a wonderful audience. And they're largely his people. I mean, these are people that really will support him. And I don't understand it. I know they're busy, but I'm busy, and we're all busy. But your show is great, and I just don't understand why he doesn't go on your show.
Look, it's not going to change my life. It won't change my life one iota. It wouldn't put a dollar in my pocket. But it will change his life.
Well, you get a lot.
You know, he and Obama are fighting over really a few 100,000 voters here and there. How could they not figure out that they need to come to the conservative radio shows in order to get these voters who are sitting on the fence to say, okay, I'll go with Romney, even though I'm not so sure about him? What's wrong with them? You know, I heard from somebody high up, Donald, that his campaign advisor voted for Obama in 08. Can you confirm that?
Well, I can't confirm it, no, but I am a little surprised to hear that. But I am more surprised to hear that he hasn't been on your show. I'm very surprised to hear that.
Well, let's move it past me. You have a Twitter site. It's Twitter at Donald Trump?
Right. At Real Donald Trump, it's called. At Real Donald Trump, right. And we've got almost 1,500,000 people. Within a few months, we'll have 2 million people. And it's blossoming. And I think the reason is because I say it like it is. I tell the truth.
You want to get a talk radio show. You don't have enough to do.
No, I don't want to compete against you. Who can compete against you, Michael?
Yeah, right.
Who wants
to compete
against you?
Not even I want to compete against me.
That's true. So, I can imagine.
So, Donald, when does the Mar-a-Lago open? Has it opened yet, your
it
great club
very
down
soon.
In...
soon. I hope you're going to be there. It opens on November 1st, And it will be another great season. We have a great club in Palm Beach called the Mar-a-Lago Club, and you've seen it, and it's an amazing place.
It opens
November 1st, Michael.
I'm going to be down there for Thanksgiving, possibly for Christmas. I'm trying. By the way, Donald, this is interesting as a side note, something positive. I met with a gentleman who works to save elephants in Africa by fighting. He actually hires groups that go out with guns and kill poachers who are killing the elephants, right?
Right.
And we're going to try and do a fundraiser for them down in the at Mar-a-Lago.
That's
Wouldn't
great.
That be a wonderful thing?
I think it's great. I actually think it's great.
Yeah. So are we going to win this election, Donald? Let's go the other way. Let's go negative. If Obama wins again, what's going to happen to this country? I mean, the taxes will go through the roof. The most productive members of society are going to freak out. They're going to try and offshore their money as fast as they can. It would be a disaster for the nation.
If he wins the election, it is going to be a very, very rough period of time, and it will be very, very hard for this country to ever recover.
In plain English. In Trump English, it'll be difficult to recover. Hey, Donald, do you think the two of us know reality because we grew up where the air and the water was good near Union Turnpike?
Right. That's right. Union Turnpike. The air was good. That's right. Union Turnpike. You know very well.
It must have been coming. It must have been Cunningham Park.
Right.
It was the Cunningham Park air that did it. Donald Trump, thanks for being with us. Hope to see you in a short time at Mar-a-Lago. Thank you very much. Remember the Twitter address. I will read it again at the end of the break. If you get a comment on any of the news topics, 1-800-449-8255.
Savage.